Prime Business Update, where business comes first.
De gemeenschap van Latijns-Amerika en het Caribisch gebied CELAC onderkent dat de regio mede verantwoordelijk is voor de productie en distributie van verboden drugs in de wereld. Aan de andere kant is ook de Europese Unie zich ervan bewust dat zij de belangrijkste markt voor cocaïne vanuit het westelijke halfrond is. De boodschap was duidelijk tijdens de 21ste EU-CELAC High Level Drugspreventie Conferentie die in Paramaribo is gehouden. Alleen door intensievere samenwerking en informatieuitwisseling zullen de EU en CELAC de grensoverschrijdende drugsproblematiek de kop kunnen indrukken.
The external factors are rapidly changing, which means that we should adjust our drug policies constantly and to be vigilant. In order to do that, we should focus on strengthening our cooperation, as countries cannot stand alone against the world drug phenomenon. As drugs cross borders and nations, so the effective policy responses should be implemented. Our responses should be based on an integrated, balanced, evidence-based approach, and of course, on enhanced cooperation, which has proven to be the most effective way in addressing the world drug situation. Let us not forget that we are all here to make a difference, a positive difference for people who use drugs worldwide and for the community as a whole, can be implemented through our joint efforts to strengthen dialogue at bi-regional level through cooperation and the exchange of good practices.
Ook Suriname ontkomt er niet aan. De grote drugsvangsten in Paramaribo, als havens in Europa, hebben voor flink wat imago-schade gezorgd. Dit wordt niet onder stoelen of banken gestoken.
With our Austrash borders, the government of Suriname recognizes the illegal drug crime as a major problem which requires an integrated approach. Not only at the national level, but certainly at the multilateral level because of the cross-border nature of the world drug problem.
Suriname bleef niet bij de pakken neerzitten. Er zijn een aantal maatregelen getroffen om de drugsmokkel via Suriname tegen te gaan. Er zijn nog meer exercities in het vooruitzicht gesteld, maar die zullen alleen middels internationale samenwerking effectieve resultaten opleveren.
The revised National Drug Master Plan, with a renewed strategy which focuses on safety and security, health, welfare and human rights, is a reflection of the President of the Republic of Suriname, His Excellency Desiree Delano Boutersen's vision of raising the drugs problem to a top priority and thereby to the level of national security. The implementation thereof consists of a sustainable balance and an integrated approach, while special emphasis is placed on capacity building, awareness, and the tightening of the necessary infrastructure in the fight against drugs-related crimes and issues. Suriname also acquires technical assistance to help formulate operational laws and implement the drugs treatment court within Suriname. Strengthening cross-border, bilateral, international collaborations with Interpol and DAA, as well as joint implementation with the seaport and the airport security program. Program El Pacto Police, Justice and Penitentiary Systems, the Citizen Security Program for Central America and the Caribbean, the Cocaine Route Program on Cocaine and Organized Crime in Latin America, and the Caribbean and the West America. Upgrading our border management system. The adaptation of this system mainly relates to the effective eradication of illegal drugs trafficking and human trafficking. In this regard, the fruitful cooperation and the successful engagements with CARICOM impacts, including the Regional Intelligence Fusion Center and Joint Regional Communication Center, should be mentioned. To achieve great success in the fight against illegal drugs as a global threat, it's very important to maintain and enhance collaboration and communication within regional, sub-regional, and international intelligence services. It is therefore essential that continuous work is carried out on diverse levels of joint corporations, mainly focusing on the level of exchange of information in a multilateral sphere.
De 21ste EU-CELAC High Level Meeting on Coordination and Cooperation Mechanism on Drugs is op 21 en 22 juni gehouden en had als thema Going Towards a Sustainable Approach. De conferentie is afgesloten met een verklaring waarin de EU en CELAC zich committeren aan meer technische samenwerking op onder andere grenscontrole en uitwisseling van inlichtingen.
Dime Business Update, where business comes first.